Vector functions are now available in Azure SQL Database in private preview. But what can you do with them? Learn all about it this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Davide from the SQL team. Davide, thanks so much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks a lot, as usual, for having me here.
It's always a pleasure, because you always bring some great demos and new announcements.
That's right.
And today's no exception, because you're going to talk to us about vector functions. So tell us, what are they? How do they work?
Yeah, so you may have known that now AI is a common discussion topic,
right? I've never heard of AI.
That's right. So basically, vectors are at the foundation of AI, because everything we need to do in order to make sure that AI works is actually store data into vectors. And the customer have been asking us for a while now to make sure that we can handle vector directly in the Azure SQL engine, so they don't have to go and make their solution more complex. And so that's why today I'm happy to announce that we are starting the early adopter preview of vector functions, so that the customer can just sign up, and we will make sure that they will have access to the vector function, which enables you to store and manipulate vectors directly in your Azure SQL database, where you already have your data, where you probably also already running complex and important queries, so also vectors now.
Cool. And so a lot of things are maybe coming together here, because we've talked about Data API Builder, which also
recently went GA.
I'd love to understand from you, like, what are some of the scenarios or ideas that you have for how this might work?
Yeah, so let's start from the basics. But what I want to build with you today is a simple query that allows you to search for a good gift to give to a teenage girl or boy, for example, actually, let's say 5 years old boy or girl. And by just looking at all the products that we have in our databases and kind of reading the description to make sure that the AI can help us to understand what is the best product.
Okay.
So pretty cool.
Cool.
Because then once you have that query, if you think about that, you can take it and expose it as a REST endpoint using Data API Builder. But to do that, you also need something else that we already published and went GA long ago, the ability to call OpenAI to get your description and turn it into a vector.
With the SP invoke external.
External REST endpoint, exactly. So that's
awesome.
Exactly what we are going to do. But let's start from the basic, first of all.
Okay,
so the first thing is, how do I create a vector? So we now have this new function called JSON array to vector that simply take a JSON array, because today JSON is everywhere, and turns it into an optimized binary format that we can actually manipulate and handle very efficiently.
Awesome.
So that's very easy. I just do JSON array to vector, and basically I have a binary version that I don't think it's useful here to show, but what I want to show you is that we also added another function called isVector that allows you to know if something contained in a binary format is actually a vector, so you can use it for other stuff. So this is not super interesting. Let's move to more interesting stuff, like, okay, when I have my own vector, and now again, I'm using here a very simple query, how do I make sure that, for example, it has the right number of dimension, or it has other properties that I want to make sure are needed for my AI model to run correctly? So here is vector again, accept some parameters, and you can even have a vector to JSON array to actually rebuild the vector from the binary format. So if you need to send it to a Python script or a C# solution, you can just return it as an array, which is, again, the most common way to handle vector outside databases. Now, let's do something more interesting right now, just to start to get used to the vector philosophy, if you want, and because vectors alone are not interesting, I would say, but they are interesting for at least us humans when we say that a vector represents something in the real world. Like here, I say, let's think about a king and a queen.
Okay.
I can turn the idea of king or the idea of queen into a number, set of number, a vector, and that set of number is called an embedding. An embedding is basically the way AI sees our world. They don't see like colors, I think, or shapes or whatever, but they see numbers, vectors. So everything we have to work on with AI is to make sure that our data is actually turned into embeddings. So what I'm doing here is using get embeddings, which is a stored procedure I created that use SP invoke external REST endpoint behind the scene to call OpenAI and turn that text king or this text queen into an embedding. Then what I'm doing is I'm storing it in a table to do something interesting later. So let me just run this. And pretty easy, just calling OpenAI, doing the the conversion, and here we go. Now, what I'm doing is I want to take the concept of queen, the idea of queen, and see if it's more similar to queen, or to pizza, just, you know, for the sake of trying. And to do that, I can do something simple called vector distance. So I want to calculate how distant are the vector that represents a queen and the vector that represents a queen or the pizza. The closer they are, the more similar they are.
Okay.
Okay. So if I have a result of zero, it means they are exactly the same thing.
Okay.
If I have a result that are closer to zero, it means they are probably similar somehow. Again, in AI mind, the higher the number, the more distant they will be, and so the more different they will be. So let's just run this query. And you see that the queen is similar to itself, so this means that our math work. And queen and king are somehow very similar. It's very close to zero, which is
okay,
obvious.
Okay, makes sense.
Now, it's interesting to see that queen and pizza are also somehow similar in AI vision of the world. Maybe queen eats pizza. I don't know. That's why AI came up with these numbers. But this is just to show you how easy it is to take two concepts that are real in the real world and use vectors to see if they are somehow similar together with the data that we already have stored in the database.
Got it. It's awesome. I have one question. You know, since maybe we decide queen and pizza in our world aren't as close together, let's say we do.
Why?
What if we had like our own model? Like, do we have to use OpenAI?
Oh, absolutely. No, you're right. That's a great question. Let's say you have your own model that maybe you have fine-tuned and trained on your own data.
For your data.
Yeah, like, for example, imagine contracts or anything that is specific to your business. So you can use that model as long as it's available as a REST endpoint, you're good to go. Today, models can be hosted in many ways. The most common one is using Ollama, for example. There are many frameworks that allows you to host your model. So as long as your model is exposed at a REST endpoint, you're good to go.
Cool.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Awesome.
Because that allows you to completely customize the way you interact with the AI. And so the last demo I have for you is let's do something serious right now. So let's say that I really want to offer my customer that are buying my stuff on a e-commerce website a way to more easily interact with the AI in a more natural language. Like I want them to be able to search for a good gift for a five-year-old girl, for example. Like, and normally what you would have to do is literally start to, you know, run a query and then start to read or check the photos, read the description and understand if it fits to your scenario or not. Or now you can convert the text, the entire text, into an embedding.
Oh.
And what the AI will do is try to come up with a vector that represents that concept. So the huge vector that you will have is something that in the AI world will actually represent a good gift for a five-year-old girl. Now, if we take all the product that we already have in our database and convert all the description into vectors, then we can ask AI, can you find the closest idea or the closest description that I already have in the product that is somehow similar to this concept that you just typed here?
Interesting.
So that's exactly what we are doing. So here I'm converting my search into an embedding, and then I'm just literally doing select from, this is a public data set that Walmart made available to play with, and I'm calculating the distance between my embedding and the embedding I calculated over the product description. So let's see what happened. And very fast, it will return some interesting results. For example, here you see that for a five-year teenage girl, you have the most similar is Polly Pocket Stunt and Style, and then Disney Tinkerbell, which, if you notice, are somehow kind of good answers.
Seems reasonable.
Exactly, exactly. So I can change it also for a boy, just to try it out and see if the answer is different. So let's see, just boy. And it shouldn't really matter because AI is smart enough to understand that maybe I made a mistake, but still the entire concept will actually be translated to a correct embedding. What I need to do is run the full script correctly. Here we go. And now for a boy, you know, build a racing car and caterpillar. Yeah, that's I like it.
But Davide, you use this category toys. Is that like a cheating hint?
Yeah, not really.
I mean, it's great because you can do that with SQL, but
yeah, that's right. No, I see what you're saying. Like, what happens if we remove that? Well, let's try and see what happens. Right? Remember that the AI is trying to find the most similar description that are somehow related to this text that I've typed here. So let's see what happens if I do that.
Still pretty good,
but now you have number five. Like, would you ever gift to someone a big number five in cardboard?
I mean, probably not, but, you know, a five-year-old might think that's pretty cool.
Could be.
But I see your toys, you can kind of...
Yeah, so somehow the number five is related to this sentence, right? Because you are talking about a five-year-old boy.
Yes.
So here we are trying to help the AI to also have some more context. And since we are human and we know that the context in this case is toys, we can help by doing something that's called hybrid search, where we mix and match the semantic search provided by vector distance and embeddings with the more regular search that you would do on a database to have a precise answer. So you can really do both right now that vector are supported in Azure SQL. Cool. So it's great.
Awesome. Cool. Well, Davide, thanks so much. Yeah. I had fun. I learned a lot.
That's cool.
To our viewers, I'm sure you learned a lot too. You enjoyed this. In the description, we're going to put a link to sign up for this private preview.
Right.
So go ahead, check out the link. Leave us a comment and let us know what you think about this new functionality. What do you want to see next? Like this episode, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.